Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, Advice to Think Twice. My name is Monica and I'm here with your weekly advice readings for the week beginning April 15th, 2019. This will be a general reading for Pisces, Sun, Moon, or Rising sign. And you can also watch this if you are dealing with a Pisces, Sun, Moon, or Rising. And if it's your Venus sign, it may also apply, especially when it comes to matters of the heart. So let's see what's coming up for Pisces in the week starting April 15th. 2019. Okay. Alright, well, Capricorn's cards did this where they just kind of picked themselves out of the deck. So I feel like they want to do the same. They're a little bit jumpy, so you either really need to receive the message, receive the guidance, or you're focused on something or stressed about something. Okay, so at the bottom of the deck we do have the Sun. So reasons to celebrate is what I'm getting with this. This is a victory card, getting what you want with the situation. This is also recognition and rewards and awards. Being in the spotlight, so either I feel like some of you are exposed to or rubbing elbows with important people, okay, for your career or for your business or for your whatever endeavors you want to further. I feel like you're in touch with the right people during this time, or the right people are paying closer attention to you than usual, okay? So everyone knows your name, they know what you're about. Great time for advertising, networking, you know, getting yourself out there. And it is a time of success. It's like you're being encouraged to pursue your goals, because it's almost like things are coming together more easily than usual. You're being put in the right circumstances with the right people to get what you want. Let's see. Right, okay. So, current situation, the Hermit. So, and the challenge is the Three of Swords. And the overall energy is the Sun. So what I'm getting at with this is, current situation is the Hermit. So you've been in Hermit mode, withdrawn to yourself, keeping yourself to yourself because you've been recovering from something. Now, I know this is true for me. I'm recovering from the end of my engagement, for example, okay? And I do feel like the Hermit, and I've been keeping myself to myself because I just don't have the energy, and there's still things to deal with and process, and I'm okay, and rationally, I'm okay. I understand everything, and I know it was the right thing, but emotionally, I'm not quite there yet, and energetically, I'm not really there yet. But with the Sun as the overall energy, you need to get yourself in the right mentality is the message, okay? So whatever it is that you are dealing with that has put you into Hermit mode, disappointment, a breakup, a loss, something that didn't turn out quite right, a fight, okay, temporary separation, whatever the case may be, that you have put yourself in Hermit mode because of, the Sun card is telling you it's time to come out into the light. It's time to be present and take advantage of this energy. Because, and by that, with the Sun, it's all about appearance. It's all about, again, just getting yourself out there, getting people to notice you, going out, socializing, going to events, going to parties, gatherings, going to meetings, courses, classes where you're involved with other people. You get to know new people, okay? And it's all about how you present yourself. So the guidance here very, very strongly is, you know what? If you have to act confident, maybe you're not feeling it, but if you have to act confident, that's what you need to do, you know? And it's like, the brain believes what we tell it. So if we act confident, then it starts believing that we are confident, you know, eventually. And we start to really come into it, you know what I mean? Now, of course, it'll be different for everyone, and you have to figure out what works for you to get you out of a state of depression, to get you out of a state of blah energy, to get you out of a state of just leave me alone, I don't want to see anyone, okay? Because again, you're rubbing elbows with all the right people during this time. So it could be a massive opportunity coming in for your career, for your business, for your financial goals, for your love life, okay? So just keep that in mind. Now, in the foundation, see, we have the World. So another card that talks about fame, recognition, and being in the spotlight, all right? You're receiving, it's like you're receiving karmic blessings and rewards for completing a massive cycle in your life, okay? And yes, it can be a relationship that ended. It can be a job that ended, a whole career that ended, a path of study that you've been invested in and a part of, and this is culmination, celebration, graduation, okay? As a result, it's like you have to adapt your energy, because as a result of this culmination, celebration, ending, completion, that leaves you kind of on your own, that you stand out from, yeah? And that could be you're alone because you're single, you're on your own because you're single now, or you are standing out because everyone knows your achievements, because everyone knows what you've done, and everyone's impressed by it, okay? So yeah, with the Hermit and the Three Swords, this energy may have served you well to get you through the process, but it's like this week in particular, the spotlight is on you, and we have to use this energy, okay? Kind of snap ourselves out of it a little bit. And you know what? With the Sun, this is also get out there, have some fun. It will do wonders for your health and well-being, okay? It's time to get out there. It's time to snap out of it a little bit. And I know it's easier said than done. And we're each in different places in recovery, emotional recovery, physical recovery, whatever the case may be. But that's the guidance. It's time to get back out there. In the past, we have the Four of Wands. So for some, this is the celebration, the culmination, again, the stability, the fame, the being welcomed, the being praised. Again, okay, it's very, very important. Reaching an important milestone, achieving a goal that gives you a sense of stability and security. Like you were made permanent because you were doing such a great job and you were a temp, but they made you permanent because, you know, they saw your worth, they saw your dedication. Or someone saw your worth and they decided they wanted to be with you, they wanted to live with you, they wanted to get married, okay, marry you and whatever. So something that was previously a celebration and it brought stability, it not necessarily that there was a breakup or a divorce, it could have been, but something went sour, something went south. Or there's distance, there's separation, there's anxiety, there's trouble, there's instability there, there's clouds, okay? And that makes you feel like you don't want to focus on anything else. But you have wonderful opportunities around you if you wanted to take advantage of them, okay? Now in the crowning thoughts, we have the Eight of Pentacles. So again, what do you want to achieve? What do you want to accomplish? What do you want to build? This is a card about building, developing, perfecting, taking something to the next level. So what do you want to present to the world? What is your service? What is your product? What is your contribution? What are your goals? What are your aspirations? You have to put it out there because, again, you're interacting with the right people and you're finding yourself in the right circumstances where people can get that for you, or they can set you on the right track. They can open the right doors for you. But it's a time to get focused. That's what this is. It's a card of focus, of zooming in. Okay, no matter what else is happening, and maybe you don't feel like it, but it's like someone coming up to you and saying, what do you wish for in your career? Tell me and I'll make it happen. And you're like, you know what, I've got so much going on at home, I can't even think about my career. And it's like, what are you doing? This person was offering to make a dream come true for you in your career. What do you mean you don't care about your career right now because you got too much going on at home? You know, so it's that kind of energy. It's like, what do you want? You can get it. Whether that's with love life, with career, with business, with any other type of goal, and whatever else it is that you're dealing with, not taking away from the difficulty, not taking away from the heaviness of what you're dealing with, but it's saying, if for now you can put that aside temporarily, look at the opportunities around you, because there are plenty, okay? This is also with the Hermit and the Three of Swords. The Three of Swords is a temporary energy. It's not something that is meant to last forever. And with the Hermit, it's saying don't stay there too long because you're making it last forever. You may make it last forever by giving it so much of your time and energy. There's a time to mourn. There's a time to cry. There's a time to be broken up and broken down. But we're not supposed to dwell there. We're not supposed to stay there. It's not healthy. It doesn't help anyone, okay? And again, I know the theory. We all know the theory. I know it's easier said than done, but I do feel like we need to be reminded, okay? What is your focus with the Eight of Pentacles, okay? Don't focus on the thoughts with the Three of Swords and the heart. Focus on the concrete, the real, the practical, the here and now, okay? What do you want? What is your focus? What is your goal towards long-term stability in your life? Okay. In the outcome, we do have the Eight of Cups. So I'm happy to see the Eight of Cups here because we are walking away from an emotionally draining situation. We're leaving it behind because we've processed it and we're done with it. Okay. It doesn't mean we're not still sad about it. It doesn't mean it still, you know, doesn't affect us, but we're not letting it consume us. Okay. That's what this Eight of Cups is. So we're moving on, moving up, moving forward. You have two eights here. Oh, Pisces too. So we have two eights here. So we're focused on the mind and in the outcome where we're headed. On long-term gain, goals, stability. We're getting our strength back. We're getting our confidence back. And if it's a case of fake it till you make it, do whatever works. Okay? And let's see what this Eight of Cups. Yeah, with the lovers, this is the commitment. That's what we're headed towards. So it could be, you know what? You have people around you. If you wanted to meet someone new, or you know what? You have jobs just around the corner if you wanted them, but you have to be present and have the conversation, you know? And when someone says, who wants to do this? Be present and be like, I will. So you're first to say it, you know? And you're headed towards that new job, that contract, that commitment, that investor. You know? That sponsor, that helping hand who will open doors for you to walk through. So, yeah. Very important that we stay focused and alert this week. Not ignore what we're dealing with. That's causing anxiety, sadness, sorrow. But maybe try to take control of it. Put it on pause if you have that ability, you know. And when you go to work, be present at work. Be there because there are options coming in. There are opportunities, great opportunities. You have three cards that talk about fame and recognition, okay? Massive opportunities. To like shoot up the ladder. But you have to be present, okay? Same thing with business, same thing with money. We have to be present. That's the Eight of Pentacles. So whatever you have to do to get yourself out of hermit mode, try it this week, okay? Because there are massive opportunities, not only for healing, recovery, getting your strength back, but for moving forward very, very far, okay? So very interesting reading here. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing how this plays out. I think I have an idea, and I can see these energies if I'm honest. Like, for example, I'm working on a project now that I'm rubbing elbows with directors in the company I work for. So how else would I have the opportunity? When else am I going to have the opportunity? So I need to be present, and I need to be professional and make a good impression, and you know what I mean? Because people remember you. So just to give you an example of what might be going on and how these energies might be playing out, you know, and even though I don't feel like it, when I get to work, I switch off and I'm at work, you know? So again, not to overshare and tell you my burdens, but to give you an example, because it's real, it's practical, to give you an example of how these energies can transpire, okay? So let me know what these cards are talking to you about. Let me know what kind of opportunities you see around yourself. Look for them, if it's just to let me know, but look for them. And yeah, report back. Let me know what this is about. Remember to watch your sun, your moon, and your rising, whatever other sign you feel like you want to watch. Have a great week, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.